と少しで回答祭ね。今年は旅館に飾り付けをしようかしら。知らない？その年の最初の満月の夜がリーユへの回答祭よ。それは英雄を祀るための祭典。夜になると人々は小塔と名称の塔を夜空に放つの。明かりには薪が尽きても火は伝わるように、美徳は永遠に消えないという意味が込められているわ。私たちは夜の海に輝く明かりが英雄の魂を故郷に導くと信じているの。
わあ、すごく盛大な祭りなんだな。それなら美味しいものもたくさんあるよな。オイラの言いたいこともちろんわかるだろう。
あなたたちも回答祭に参加するの？回答祭当日まではしばらくお祭りは続くわよ。この期間中に人々は祈祷を捧げたり厄払いをしたりするの。リーユへの言葉で言うと、古きを送り新しきを迎えるね。もし参加したいのなら今からでも間に合うわよ。それと、もし行くのなら、その試しに将様も誘ってあげてくれないかしら。将様と私たちはそこまで親しい間柄じゃないから、ちょっと声をかけにくいの。
うん、今声をかけに行くのはあまり良くないような。
そうなの？ならいいわ、ちょっと行ってみただけなの。ほら、早くリーウェ校に行ってきなさい。遅くなると人がみんな集まってくるわ。そうなると遊ぶのも大変よ。早く行きなさい。回答祭を楽しんでおいで。
Hello everyone, welcome back to Genshin Impact. To you it might have been some days, to me it was some minutes after I finished recording the Xiao character quest. So, I did a different intro to the quest because it is an event, and I decided to start with the first part of the story. Not because I wanted to be original, but because to start this quest I had to complete a ton of secondary quests, and I was going crazy in my previous recordings because I didn't understand what I was doing wrong. And of course Kevin has to start talking randomly over me, but you get the idea. So basically I did like 5 or 6, 7 recordings before I realized what I had to do, but now we are ready to go and start this new event. So you saw that we got tasked to go and celebrate this new Lantern Festival. As you can see, a very beautiful background in Liyue, quite enjoying it so far. Let's hope that it delivers also in the story department, unlike the Shulk Prince and the Dragon, which was kinda... It had a good premise, it fell flat at the end.
Sogono-nii-chan, sono tonari ni ukandeiru chibi wa ikura de utteiru no kana?
What the hell? Okay, so I want to talk during cutscene, guys, don't worry.
Naka okashii zo! Demo, shoujiki ni iu to, chotto kini naru na. Ittai ikura da? Ma, ikura tsumarete mo, uru ki wa nai toyukoto ni shite oku ka.
Hahaha, tashika ni saikin wa futokoro ni yoyu ga nai kara, amari dasenai kamo na. Nani se futsuu no shounin da. 珍しい宝物を売っているわけではない。
なんか怪しいぞこいつ。
そう言わないで。そうだ、飴食べる？
こいつは信頼できるやつだ。
そうだ、君たちも回答祭目当てでリーウェに来たんだろ。今年の名称の塔はとにかくすごい。巨大な塔を浮かせるために使った浮上の石はここ20年で最も大きいものだ。神話に出てくる雲の中の城が本当に実在していたら、きっと同じぐらい大きな浮上の石がくっついているんだろうな。
なんかすごそう。
ようこそリーウェイ。リーウェイ校の代表としての言葉ではないが、少なくとも私の店はいつでも君を歓迎するよ。機会があればまた会おう。
Yeah, it's really... It's really pretty how they decorated the city. I look forward to see also Mostad Festival. This little girl was one of the pesky secondary quests that I had to do. My wish is to pull for Hu Tao. Ooh. Are those some chests? Are those some fake chests? I got tricked.
今年の名称の塔のデザインは衣装道天神君か。見栄えを気にするあやつが喜びそうじゃの。鹿の角をもっと大きくしてくれるといいんじゃが。何せ鹿の角は あの仙人の誇りじゃったからの。その角には岩王帝君の力が込められておって、リーユエで最も固いものだった。しかしあの決戦で山が崩れそうになり、彼は麓にいた人々を守るため、自ら角を切ってくれと友人に頼んだんじゃ。彼は切り落とされた角を支点にして山を支えた。 彼自身も最後の一滴の血が流れるまで戦ったんじゃ。今になってもなお、彼の角に支えられた天鉱山は高くそびえ立っておる。そして彼が戦いで流した血は、碧水川となった。信じてくれるかどうかは別として、この話を聞いてくれただけで、バーヤは満足じゃ。 怪盗祭が今もあり続けているのは、あの旧友たちが寂しがり屋だからかもしれないの。さようなら。オーコライコン、美徳の精神が続かんことを。
Okay, so I don't like having the day on the background because I feel like the night is more pretty as a whole. And this is a sort of walkthrough video, not a walkthrough of course, but it is not like the character story where I pay more attention to what I'm doing. So here I want to make sure that we have pretty stuff so I can enjoy the event to its full. 21:45 seems like a decent time. There we go, they are back. I wonder if they are models or if they are a part of the background, because they look very, very cool. This other guy, Xiang Zhu, was another one with... This girl, rather, was another one with the secondary quest that brought me problems. Let's see what she has to say.
の塔の材料、浮上の石。この小市はそのために作られたものだよ。誰？名称の塔の建設進捗統計を担当している甲州だ。君たちは最近リーユエに来たばかりで、怪盗祭を見るのも初めてかな。そうだけど、どうしてわかったんだ？去年は変わったマスコットを連れた旅人なんていなかったからさ。怪盗祭で 人々が飛ばす小さな帝塔が小塔で、リーユエのみんなが共同で建設した巨大な帝塔が名称の塔だよ。小市の屋台はリーユエの各商会が年に一度お金のためではなく名称の塔を建設するために開いたものだ。じゃあ小市には美味しいものもたくさんあるのか？もちろん。私に言わせれば、怪盗祭はリーユエの美食を味わう最高の機会だ。 これはリーユエの一年のうちで最も盛大な祭りだ。怪盗祭で自分の技術をみんなに披露すれば評判もかなり上がるだろう。だから金にはならなくとも各商店は全力を出し、怪盗祭で己の技を競い合うのさ。
リーユエ人はいろんな面ですごいんだな。
まだ何か聞きたいことがあったら 怪盗祭の責任者であるボーガさんを探してみるといい。ボーガさんは基本小一のあたりにいる。彼女に聞けばいろいろと教えてくれるはずだ。
そいつはどの店の料理が一番おいしいのかも知ってるのか。
当然さ、ボーガさんは怪盗祭の全てに詳しいからね。
わかった、早く小一に行ってそのボーガさんを探そう。それで一番おいしい屋台でお腹いっぱい食べるんだ。
So in mid it's strange that those characters I met 2 minutes ago say, ah, who are you? Like, we just met. But I guess they can't do everything like the Fishland Mona event, so I give them a pass, but it just felt weird that I said, okay, I talked with this lady a minute ago, and then she goes, oh, oh, who are you with the random fairy? I mean, lady, I just met you to complete the quest. Okay, so we also need to talk to the lady, which was directly behind her, but let's see what she also has to say.
こんにちは。何か用かしら。あなたの格好、リーウェの人じゃないよね。旅人かしら。小一へようこそ。責任者とも言えないわ。怪盗祭はリーウェ全体の祭りなのだから、誰かが責任を取るものでもないもの。私はただ細かい部分を管理して怪盗祭をもっと盛り上げているだけよ。
超一で一番おいしい屋台はどこなんだ？
一番？それぞれに特徴があるからはっきりした答えは出せないわ。ただ一番人気の屋台なら知っているわね。疑念の屋台よ。あそこに並ぶ人がもう少し増えたら千貫軍に行列の整理をしてもらう予定よ。行くなら急いだ方がいいわ。人が増えて道が埋め尽くされる前にね。そうだ、疑念のところに行くのならついでにこの書類を彼に渡してちょうだい。これは我々総務士が昨年の怪盗祭のデータをもとに作成した各商店への経営提案よ。どうせ行くのならついでに手伝ってくれる？戻ってきたらお礼としてちょっとしたプレゼントをあげるわ。
If the gifts isn't 10 intertwined fates, then we don't need it. I'm joking, but we get some sweet free food. Hopefully we can buy it, because I do need the food, because I don't really like to farm food.
人手が足りないな。もう少し人を連れてくるべきだった。
ここはどんな美味しいものがあるんだ？
お客さんかい？メニューはこっちだ。メニューにあるものもないものも何でも作れるからね。
それじゃあ、小さな屋台だけど何でもあるようだな。
当然さ、僕に作れない料理はないからね。さ、早く注文して。また今年も来たか。経営提案なんて、僕は料理の味以外で勝負する気はないのに。まあいい、書類をくれる？後で巻き代わりにでもするよ。さ、食事しに来たのなら注文してくれ。
こんなにメニューがあるなんて、これも美味しそうだな。あ、こっちも食べたい。
あれ、チコ魚焼き？あ、これ確か道塾が好きだった料理だよな。
うん、怪盗祭が英雄を祀るための祭りならこの料理にしよう。これで
なかなか見る目があるな。うちの看板メニューをいきなり当てるなんて。少し待っていてくれ、すぐにできるから。はい、注文してたチコ魚焼きだよ。味はどう？
おいしい。お前の最高の仲間として当然のことだ。
ゆっくり食べてくれ。僕は次のお客さんを対応しないと。まだ何か食べたかったらいつでも注文してくれ。
Okay, so that was a cool connection to the Xiao character quest with the Cervantes guy. If you guys haven't seen it, go check it out. Nothing major, but a cool connection to it, which is why we had to do it to unlock the event itself. Let's get this gift.
どう？記念の料理はなかなかだったでしょう。
すごく美味しかったぞ。
そう、去年もそんな感じだったわ。私たちの提案通りに広告を出してくれれば売り上げがもっと増えるはずなのに。まあいいわ。ほら、さっき言ったプレゼントよ。この小灯をあげるわ。
おー、すごく綺麗な明かりだ。これってどうやって作るんだ？
編み方は私もうまく説明できないわ。もし小灯に興味があるのなら、慶明に聞いてみるといいわ。彼は小灯と名称の塔の責任者よ。
あの、すごく大きい明かりもその人が担当しているのか？
ええ、彼はその辺にいるだろうからすぐに見つかると思うわ。
小灯を編んでショーにプレゼントしたら少しは喜んでくれるかも。早く慶明を探しに行こう。
Yeah, let's find him and see what he has to say. Man, it gets to the day so fast. I can't enjoy the background. I want to use the time passing feature or whatever. I wonder when the story characters come in, because so far it has been only characters from the city, which is fine actually. I like to see also NPCs doing something rather than just being NPCs.
Shoto's amikata? Oh, yeah. Kimi no kakko, kono tochi no ningen janai ne. Jibun de shoto o amitai no ka? Kono pe. Shoto ni wa ironna type ga aru kara na.一番簡単なものの作り方を教えてあげよう。ちょうどここに材料があるんだ。おっと、この材料はまず処理を施す必要があったな。まずはこれで試しに作ってみてくれ。
OK, conversion function. This is, I believe this was added with the batch. OK, don't need it right now. We need to craft the lantern. So we got those from the Xiao character quest while we were looking for the flowers. Actually got a ton of lantern fibers. I need to get the weak materials from Ilchards and those from Zhao Bishops. Okay, so I guess I will have to do some farming off video. Let's see if there is a bonus to someone that can craft. I don't believe there is. I also got Xinyan. I believe we got her in video or whatever, so I might be remembering wrong. Okay, let's craft it. There we go. Also, this guy dialogue was kind of bugged, honestly.
Hajime
wa muzukashii kamo shirenai ga, kazu o konaseba nareru sa. Kimi tachi no you ni, shoutou no amikata o oboetai toyou hito wa, mou sou ouku nai.
あの超巨大な名称の塔もこうやって編んで作ったのか？
あれか？あれも編んだと言えるだろう。だが一人ではなく、リーウェにいる全てのものが一緒に編んだんだ。
リーウェにいる全てのものが？
君も知っているだろう。超一の商店がこの名称の塔を建設するためにここに集まっているの。
なるほど。名称の塔は毎回商店の力を借りて作られてるのか。
これは怪盗祭の伝統だ。必要な費用は主に総務士からの寄付金だが、材料やその他もろもろは全て一般の人々が寄付したものだ。
あ、この前の女の子、自分のぬいぐるみを寄付してたよな。ぬいぐるみも名称の塔の建設に使えるのか？
それは怪盗祭は大きな祭りだ。みんなが名称の塔の建設に参加したいのなら、何を寄付したとしても基本全て受け取るようにしている。思いが込められているからな。何せ盛大な祭りだ。参加することで祝福を受けたいという人もいるだろう。おっと、君たちは怪盗祭を楽しみに来たのだろう。引き止めてすまないね。また小灯を編みたくなったら私のところに来てくれ。怪盗祭を楽しんでくれよ。
Okay, so we need to go back to the inn. No, to the girl right here. I wonder where Xiao will come into play. I do think that the cutscene that they add for the trailer will come whenever we get to the actual Chinese New Year, which should be February the 14th, but we will see.
どう?ケイミョンは見つかった?見つけたぞ!消灯の作り方も教えてくれた!複雑すぎて全部覚えられなかったけど。大丈夫よ。覚えきれなかったらまたケイミョンに消灯の作り方を聞きに行けばいいわ。よし、私はそろそろ仕事に行かなきゃ。街灯祭を楽しんでね。
Ok, kinda anticlimatic. We've only just begun, ok. The game already came in clutch. All that glitters, Lantern Rite Tales, Xiao Market. So the Xiao Market, I believe, will be the shop, indeed. Dust of Azoth, this is for the conversion that we saw earlier. And we have three different shops, all with the same currency, however. Look at this. So indeed, there are three parts to this event, like I expected. And I believe that even though we get a currency for each one, those will be unlocked later on in the event. Doesn't seem any crazy rewards right here, I guess this one is pretty cool. But we have the usual materials, the usual level up stuff, the ground insight, always good to have. And then some ascension materials as well. I will buy anything because I love tower defense if it's done right. Then this, we need to complete the Theater Mechanicus quest to unlock. This one, Tails, seems to be troubled by something. So this, I believe, is the main quest, which we will do right now. Then we have all that glitters, which was... Daylight is the release of the giant, ok. I guess this is actually the true main quest that we will have to do. So this one we will do in 3 days, which I believe is actually 4, because if it is 3 and some hours, then this unlocks actually on the 14th. Okay, so it lines up. Sorry, I was thinking about it. I guess so, those interruptions that I have are kinda pointless. Stand by me. This is the free 4 star. So I have Xianglin, I have Xinyan, I have Xingqiu. I get in the names. I have Chongyun. My choice will be between Beidou and Ningguang. I believe that I am getting Ningguang. If you guys want a Shulyu pull, I suggest that you go for her, Xinyan, or for Ningguang. Both of them are actually very good, from what I heard. Okay, let's do those Lantern Rite. Ah, wait, maybe those are just side quest. Let's check it out. I'm curious. Yeah, they are side quest. I want to do the... how it is called? The tower defense. First, let me see if this is just a secondary quest. Okay, yeah, it is. This will be skipped. Like, I know that there is a story behind the secondary quest for sure, but I don't really care a whole lot because it's not voiced and the reading. Means that it gets kinda weird for me, if you guys know what I mean. I prefer when characters are talking rather than myself, because if I read the text, probably you guys won't understand anything. That's my main worry for it. Okay, so I want to do this, however. I want to see how the tower defense is. Where do we have to go? Talk to Regine. Talk, not talk, as you can see. Just as I was saying, talk to Regine. Let's see if we can do the tower defense. Hello, would you like to play a round of Theater Mechanicus? What's that? Oh, never heard of it? Allow me to introduce it to you then. Theater Mechanicus is a kind of tabletop games invented by yours truly. Do you see the pieces laid out on the table here? These are all important items in the game of Theater Mechanicus. Looks complicated. Yeah, it may be complicated, but you'll get the hang of it after you play a couple of times, indeed. So, how about it? Would you like to give it a try? Must be pretty expensive. No, no, no. It's the Lantern Knight, after all. Besides, I was hoping to collect everyone's initial impression of the game. So, all it costs you to play is a single Xiao Lantern. So, this is where the crafting comes into play, if I had to guess. If you'd like to try, just bring me a Xiao Lantern and you'll be good to go. Ok. Come on, give it a try. I will let you play the first round for free and you can keep your Xiao Lantern. There we go. This is the tower defense. Before challenge a stage, to unlock a new mechanic. Okay. Okay. Nice to, for them to leave it in whatever language. I guess this is Chinese. Two players. Up to, so we can even do it solo. Okay. The beginning, you can choose a stage Mystic Art. Okay, so those are power-ups. So you need... Okay, so this is a tower defense, basically. Trial stage, so we have to do the trial. I guess the trial is a good way for the video, because usually doing it live makes me look bad because I will be a noob the first time. So next time we will do it properly whenever the second part of the story comes out. Which... okay. Stage features, activate wind current. Okay, I get it. So here we have the traps. And we decide which traps to activate. So what we can construct here. Okay, so I want water, I guess. Because we have a Kegwing. One here should be fine. Then I do want to activate the wind one. I read that it's actually very good. Ah, okay, it's not a trap. You get it to do the fall down attack. Okay, that's right. Let's put... Not a fire one, a nice one right here. And then we put a regenerate one. This one, recovery MK, one right here. Then we do some slowdown with the ice one right here. Oh, it's about to start. Okay, I guess it is good to go. I like this mod. It already seems very interesting to play with. Because there is a strategy around it, and I guess that it can get very difficult in the future. Okay, you can start it even immediately. Yes, yes, let's start. Do not allow more than 30 monsters to escape. Okay, let's see. Oh, they are tough. Is this timed? No, it's not timed. But we have to use the towers maybe to damage them. Ah, I get it now. So you can't do damage to them. You have to basically let the towers do the job. Ok, so this adds a layer of complexity to the whole thing. There we go. The effect of a Figle can only be pyromechanic. Ok, I like this one. Ok. Ok, I'm not sure what was going on there, but we got a power up, so... The interactive field... can now be used. What is their interactive field? I need to get used to this. But I will get used to this very quickly. Okay, let's start the wave since we don't have any more construction stuff, but... I like the idea. For sure, a tower defense mode in a game like this might seem sort of a novelty, for sure, because we probably never expected this one in a gacha. Usually gachas don't have tower defense, but Arknights exist, so I want to be proven wrong most of the time. One thing that I want to say is that probably an emo character right here are pretty good because they can knock back by a lot and maybe even throw the enemies down in the middle, so... Luckily, we have an expert Genshin player right here, so... No problem at all. I wonder why they decided for units to not deal damage, however. I guess it is true to the spirit of a tower defense, otherwise it will just be a glorified normal mod where the character doesn't do anything. However, it will mean in co-op that if you don't have Jin, the Anemo Traveler, or where else can it be? Let me think. Venti, yeah, Venti will be OP as hell in this mode. I wonder what this tower in the middle does, because I'm not really sure at this point. Okay, electromechanic range, maybe we'll take this. Gain 20, okay, this one. It's nice, because we can build more towers. Because we get an Anemo Sarlashul very soon. So here we want to buy this one. Then here we want to buy, so wait. This one right here is water, so I want another electric one right here. Which interacts very well with the facial. Sorry, not facial, K-Wing. Then I want a fire here. Good enough. And then maybe I can upgrade them. No, it doesn't seem like I can upgrade them. I can dismantle them, however. Okay, defeated. Ah, okay, it gives you bonus points if you defeat enemies in an area around it. Okay, I get the general idea. So you want to do something like this, if I have to guess. Let's go like this, seems a cool setup. Let's start it. I will cover the left flank because it is not very well defended right now. Yes, I want to put a fire here as well. Oh, look at those guys, they go very fast. Let me deal with this one. That one is dead. Okay, so I want to look at this without doing something, if it works. Yeah, so you can see that the electric tower and the fire towers are sort of long range, while the water and the ice one are short range. At least it seems like to be like that. Where are you going? No, this guy is going to make it. Just kidding. I wonder, I want to check something, if this does anything. So if we do... No, doesn't seem like to do damage. So I guess it is only towers that do stuff. I guess it is interesting. Let me know in the comments if you like this mod, guys. It is probably very, very innovative for an event, because it is temporary after all. Strategizing a whole new mod just for an event seems like a whole lot of work for sure. Not sure how they managed it with all the stuff they have been going in the background. If the rumors that we get two regions very close to each other are true. I do believe that we'll get Inazuma and then shortly after the Dendro region, whatever it is called, the forest. I am waiting anxiously to see the new regions, probably my most awaited feature for this game, but it will be a long time. Okay, so we are done with this. What do we have to say, lady? I'll play around. Let me see just how the panel for this mod looks like. Oh, you have even a difficulty multiplier. 3.0, this one, they will go extra fast. Okay, so I will start this off video, try to upgrade it as much as I can, and let you guys know how it goes. Let's see if we unlocked everything for the event. Tether mechanics, yes, we did. So these are basically the quest. Reach the stage of festive fever. Complete the quest current deep. Complete all the Hunter Time Tales. Interesting, interesting. Ok, so this is it for the start of this event. Of course this is only the start. I will try to understand how the story goes, but remember that I mainly want to cover the story and of course the gameplay that comes with it. So next I will probably wait for the first part of the story to begin, which I believe should be this one, unlocked in 3 days, but we will see. For today, guys, once again, thank you very much for watching this Genshin Impact video. Remember to give a like and a sub if you want to support the channel, and remember if you are celebrating the Chinese New Year to have a wonderful New Year from yours truly. I don't follow the Chinese calendar, but I still wish for your own 2021 to be beautiful. So, once again, thank you very much. This has been Hunter Lodge. Let me know in the comments if you liked the event as a whole. Also, I want to know feedback about the event. and we will see each other very soon, with Kewing, with me, and also, hopefully, with Wu Tao, if she comes in this event as a guest or a cameo, whatever she will be. So, bye guys, see you next time.